आप सुन रहे हैं रेडियो उड़ान विद आरजे पुलकित के साथ।
हाय गाइस, दिस इज पुलकित। वेलकम 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 टू माय शोज। एक्चुअली दो शोज हैं, ये यूट्यूब पे भी जाने वाला है बिकॉज मैंने कभी यूट्यूब पे जाना नहीं, एंड ये मेरे पॉडकास्ट पे भी जाएगा माय टॉपिक लेस टफरी, और ये मेरे रेडियो उड़ान के लिए भी जाएगा। सो गाइस, आई एम सो हैप्पी टुडे बिकॉज यू नो, मतलब आज एक ऐसी पर्सनालिटी मेरे साथ है जो एक बहुत अच्छी स्टैंड अप कॉमेडियन है, एंड वो काफ़ी जोक क्रैक करती हैं। अभी बैठे बैठे दो जोक क्रैक कर चुकी है मेरे ऊपर ही, एंड आई एम फीलिंग सो वर्ड कि मैं एक बहुत ही हम्बल पर्सन फील कर रहा हूँ कि यहाँ पे मेरे साथ एक मजाक किया। आप तुसी तो बड़े मजाक किया ना, वैसे वो वाली पर्सन है, तुसी तो
बड़े मजाक किया, बड़े मजाक किया हम तो, अरे
मैं बहुत अच्छा हूँ, एंड थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग बिकॉज मेरे को लग नहीं रहा था कि यार ये पॉसिबल हो पाएगा बिकॉज आप इतनी बिजी रहती हैं अपने शोज वगैरह में, एंड यू नो
मतलब तुम खींच रहे हो या मतलब एग्जैक्टली वो कह रहा है यहाँ पर, या बिकॉज तुमने मुझे आज ठीक बोला है और मैंने तुम्हें डेट दे दी, ठीक है?
ओके,
रिस्पांस दैट आई हैव एवर।
तो बेसिकली आप श्वेता को जानते ही हैं बिकॉज ये काफी ज्यादा यू नो शोज करती हैं, स्टैंड अप करती हैं, और ये पुणे से है। तो श्वेता हमारे साथ इसलिए भी जुड़ी हैं बिकॉज हमारे साथ बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन पे अपने जो मैंने इनके लिए सेट किए हैं और उस पर हम बात करने वाले हैं आज। तो श्वेता, मैं आपसे क्वेश्चन पूछना शुरू करूं अगर आप इजाजत दे दो।
सवाल पूछ लिया
था। ओके तो श्वेता, मेरा सबसे पहला क्वेश्चन है आपके लिए। सबसे पहला क्वेश्चन, हु इज श्वेता मंत्री? Yes, very much.
किसी ने टिंडर पर भी नहीं पूछा, Who are you? What are you? बताइए। So, I think श्वेता मंत्री is as human as she can get. She's a real human person. And the reason why I'm saying this is because I don't believe in putting up a face, you know, or creating an image for myself. You know, जब हम वो टीनेज में होता है ना, we look for quotes online that describe us, right? So I'd come across this one quote that said, "Born to be real, not perfect." So I think that's what describes me the most. Because I mean, my friends and family know me for being the most candid person ever. So If right now I'm not in a good mood, I will say that, you know.
Okay.
My Instagram is not all happy at all. Instagram is very real. I talk about not getting access to things. I talk about my crush is not responding to me. Okay. I talk about bombing on stage, which is a very frequent occurrence. Okay. So stuff like that. It's as real as it can get. So I'm a very real person, and please don't expect me to be happy and smiling all the time, because that's not what humans are made for. Mm-hmm. We're made to experience and go through multiple things, multiple emotions. So yeah, I think it's all about embracing whatever life throws your way.
Yeah. आज कोई आएगा, खोल देगा राज या फिर राज खुद बन जाएगा। रात के आगोश में ये राज रहने दीजिए, कल खुलासा आज रहने दी।
This is guys. This is the first time I'm meeting her because we sit normal, मतलब Zoom call
basically. Following each other on
that's it. We are just following each other and right. Like liking each other posts and all this because हमारे पास ज़्यादा time नहीं होता है एक दूसरे से बात करने के लिए. सच्ची बताऊँ.
हाँ मतलब बड़े लोग RJ podcaster.
Yeah, exactly. And big stand up comedians, you know. Who does not
you have other famous people following you and all so much God.
No. They're also busy. Wo bhi reply nahi karte. Okay. Mera dusra question beta aapse hai. Like why you chose comedy? ठीक है इसी के साथ एक और क्वेश्चन मैं जो जोड़ रहा हूँ इन टर्म्स ऑफ एक्सेसिबिलिटी ठीक है लाइक रेस्टोरेंट में जाते हैं आप ओपन माइक लाइक शोज करते हैं वो कितना सपोर्टिव है फॉर PWD के लिए बिकॉज वहाँ पे मैंने देखा है कि कभी कभार ऐसी जगह भी होती है जहाँ पे आप खुद क्लाइम नहीं करते बिकॉज वो एक तो सीढ़ियां बहुत होती हैं ठीक है कई जगह पे एलिवेटर्स नहीं होते हैं एंड लाइक हाउ यू मैनेज ऑल दीज थिंग्स बाय योरसेल्फ
या सो व्हाई आर यू डूइंग कॉमेडी सो टू बी एज ऑनेस्ट एंड रियल सेकंडली आई ग्रू अप टू बिकम अ वेरी not a very but I grew up to become somebody who wasn't happy you know
okay.
with mm-hmm. the way she was being treated mm-hmm. Or the way people were stereotyping her or labeling her or putting her into a box that was convenient to them you know mm-hmm. like for example I was in a school for able girls mm-hmm. and there was one more girl with me who had a similar disability. So mm-hmm. we were told ki nahi nahi ground par mat jao gir jaoge mm-hmm. PT session mein mat jaya karo class mein baithke homework kiya karo
okay
you know or like we had a helper in school so
yeah.
we were sent back home and when the helper would not turn up because the authorities wouldn't trust us to take care of ourselves
exactly.
Or like even like parents saying things to you or being so overprotective that you know they land up restricting the kind of activities that you take part in at home
mm-hmm.
you know? or like people telling you ki ha like if you're at a family function yahan mat jao idhar hi baitho I'll get you a plate I'll get you something. मैंने कहा ठीक है मेरा वॉशरूम ठीक है लेके आ जाओ हाँ ठीक है लेके आ जाओ
Please bring it here. यहीं पे हो जाएगा सारा काम जाने नहीं पड़ेगा
To going to college where you know you want to of course you're in a teenage you want address you want attention from the opposite gender but then Welcome. You don't land up getting it because you look different and you are different you know you're not regular and normal So mm-hmm. that is, those were some reasons. The other reasons were basically lack of accessibility. I grew up in the 90s, so I going to places that didn't have an accessible washroom, or not being able to stay at places longer because of the lack of accessible washroom, you know, or mm-hmm. not going to places because it didn't have a lift. So this kya bolte the culmination of physical and psychological experiences or the mm-hmm. culmination of the physical and psychological barriers that I experienced mm-hmm. like to become a person who felt the need to to talk about disability and to at least initiate a dialogue and try and bring about a change. So I was doing that for quite some time, and then I reached a point where I was told that I'm very harsh in the narrative. I'm very blunt.
Why?
Because, yeah, people didn't want to hear the real story, na, because unfortunately, in the society that we live in, you always want people with disabilities to be happy, and oh my god, always so smiling, so cheerful, oh my god, so inspiring.
Inspiring, that's the word.
That's the word. So when someone talks about real issues and things that matter to them and things that impact them hugely, people are not comfortable. So yeah. I was told that I am not, I need to mellow down, tone down. To change the way I matlab wo hai na ki people always tell the oppressed how to react and respond. People don't change the way they react to a certain set of people so that they are no longer the oppressed set of people.
Because maine kafi dekha hai ki aise, you know, oh god, you're very inspiring, and I'm like, yeah, right. I know that.
Right, exactly. I know that. Then, because of all of this, I was like, okay, let me try and talk about disability through stand-up comedy. It was I wouldn't say it was the most calculated decision of my life. It was supposed to be an experiment, and I didn't think that I will land up pursuing it for a long period of time. I'm like, oh god, it will be one of my side jobs,
and believe me, it is working. Stand-up comedian female who is like person with disability.
Nidhi Goyal was.
He's not active.
He's not doing stand-up actively.
Even I saw her in some of us, like she was interviewing one of my friends. I don't know. I saw her like हाँ मैंने उनको देखा था एक बार लाइक इंटरव्यू में. शी इज वेरी विटी यू नो. शी इज वेरी विटी.
शी
इज वेरी विटी. आई नो शी इज लाइक I think she is visually impaired and she is very witty. And literally, I told my friend that time, yeah, please, inka autograph le liyo, please. Literally, because itna laga rahe ki wo itna witty ho sakta hai and itna, she is amazing. Okay.
So, that's how I ended up doing stand-up comedy. And the reason why I'm still doing it is because I get to sit in some stage that I don't get to say in real life. Like, tackle the nosy uncle aunties, tackle the questions. So, tackle the boys who dump you.
So. Yes. Okay. So, like, ab move on karte hain. Isi ke saath ek aur question tha ki, like, restaurants kaise aapke saath,
right.
How they are supportive? Like, kya? Kuch aisa incident kuch hua?
So, I mean, how do I say this? I think we're just conditioned and as a society to maybe not cater to the needs of or to not cater to the not so regular needs or needs of people with disabilities or needs of people who need more accommodation than Absolutely. The regular accommodations, Absolutely. Right? So by default, I mean, and unfortunately that is the default right now. Hmm. So by default, yes, restaurants are inaccessible. Okay. I've had to miss open mics because I can't be at certain spaces. And that's just become an everyday thing right now. Like, and the there are times when I call up the producer to ask them details about the venue. I'm from Pune, so when I go to Bombay, I do my research beforehand to know which club, which space, which venue is accessible and which is not. And I think 30% of them are not accessible and I can't go. You know, right from having huge steps, steep steps, no railing, no washroom. Washroom and venue being on a different level, you know.
Yeah,
or venues being in a commercial complex where the washroom is common and then you cannot access it because it's just not accessible, slippery, dry, whatever. Matlab dry to nahi hota hai, but slippery, dry, wo sab, you know, you have to keep calculating, figuring out, and that leads to like.
Matlab wo aisa lagta hai ki jaise wo ek sci-fi show hai, ek, you know.
it's like a Khatron ke Khiladi people with disabilities edition. And I'm not kidding because there have been times where I've fallen down. And I am holding an ice cube in my hand. Lagar baithi hu and they like, oh, bring it on, bring out the next act.
And uske baad 50 log aate hain. Kya hua? Theek hai, everybody okay. Kya hua?
And instead of acknowledging you for your jokes or kya bolte hain, understanding your narrative. Uh-huh. From a very non-judgmental space, people start sympathizing because they've seen you fall or struggle or whatever. So, what I'm trying to say is that yes, venues are inaccessible. However, people are extremely kind and helpful, right from the producers to the venue owners. They've all been extremely accommodating. We've had conversations where they've asked me what are my needs, what do I need, and how they can make the entire experience more easy for me. Okay. So that's it.
And believe me, I'm very bad at stand-up comedy.
कैसे मिले दिल न जानो अब क्या करें
मेरा अगला क्वेश्चन इसी पे ही है तो लाइक व्हाट वाज द रिएक्शन बाय पीपल व्हेन दे वॉच यू ऑन स्टेज एंड हाउ यू फेल्ट
I think sometimes people so stand up is a journey, okay? Unless you're like really want to do stand up comedy or comedy, you're not going to get it right from your first open mic or your fifth open mic, right? You keep growing with every open mic that you perform in, with more stage time basically. So that's one part where you bomb and then you do okay and then you do well, and then and that's how the audience responds to you. But the other aspect of it is, you know, sometimes people respond, the way people respond to me, sometimes it's, they laugh only because they're just so much in awe of the fact that there is a disabled person on stage who is cracking jokes, you know, a disabled person is out there in public. Sometimes they don't even want to listen to your punchline. They're just laughing.
पहले 5 मिनट तो स्टेयर करते होंगे उसके बाद सोचते हो यहां हंसना है
नहीं मतलब थैंकफुली क्या था कि पहले आई वुड गो एंड डू माय जोक्स राइट विदाउट एनी बिगिनिंग ओपनिंग लाइन और स्टफ लाइक दैट बट देन आई रियलाइज दैट देन आई रियलाइज दैट पीपल स्टेयर पीपल डोंट नो हाउ टू रिएक्ट है ना पीपल आर कंफ्यूज कि क्या चल रहा है हमारे सामने So then I realized that there needs to be this one icebreaker line that I have to say, which will put the audience. So
वो कैसे करती हो? वो comfort कैसे बिठाती हो उनके साथ? Like how you, like you know, उनके साथ comfortable होना है audience के साथ. वो एक बहुत important factor भी है.
हाँ हाँ. I think what I am doing right now is having 2-3 one-liners at the beginning. Before I start doing my usual setup and same jokes, which will make the audience realize that okay, she is somebody who doesn't take her disability seriously. She is somebody who is cracking, how to crack jokes on her disability, or she is somebody who is okay with also saying dark stuff. Mm-hmm. So I think that's what the first 20 seconds need to do for me, and I figured that maybe 6 months down the line. Because even though my jokes were good, people would still not be comfortable. So I realized that I need to first do my icebreaker stuff and then move on. So people, some people laugh just because they're happy that a disabled person is, or they're inspired because a disabled person is out there doing comedy. Sometimes there are sympathy laughs. हाँ ठीक है ट्राई तो कर रही है ना बेचारी तो दुखी होगी अच्छा है बाहर आके कॉमेडी कर रही है सो स्ट्रॉन्ग सो ब्रेव सो नाइस एंड देन देयर आर सम पीपल बिकॉज आई फील लाइक बिकॉज देयर ओन कंडीशनिंग दे डिडंट अलाउ देमसेल्व्स टू काइंड ऑफ बी ओके विद लाफिंग एट डिसेबिलिटी एंड देन देयर इज ऑफ कोर्स अ यूजुअल ऑडियंस दैट that goes with the flow and who respond to you, you know, so that's the best kind of amalgamation.
I'm hoping ki ye jo ek mind ka unka jo hai kya bolu main isse mere ko word nahi aa raha wo tootega
internalized ableism right in the sense how can we laugh at disability
haan ye to bichari hai kya kar legi bichari chodo yaar something like that
or more than bichari it's also like as I mentioned to you like I'm somebody who believes in calling out things for what they are or believes in not fabricating things so when I talk about the real stuff like when I talk about somebody helping me when I don't want to be helped someone helping me cross the road trying to talk about say maybe cab drivers being super nice to me for no reason not taking money from me or whatever things like that
acha okay
thank you matlab jo bhi hai I hope ho jaye ek bar to bhi to maro wants that to happen sometime but when I escalate or exaggerate these situations some people are like oh why is she addressing it you know they want me to talk about other things as well like I've gotten this feedback from the audience members and from other comics that hey why don't you talk about why don't you do regular normal jokes and I'm like yeah fine thank you but why because until the point I reach on stage I am labeled as disabled the moment I get on stage why do you want me to shed off that label and then be something that I am not or be something that makes you comfortable
Maybe someday, maybe some good day, I will crack a normal joke, but normal joke mein hoon.
But my point is, I will if I want to. Right now, I feel like this because my comedy comes from an emotional space, I feel. You know, because there are some things that I want to talk about, there's some things I want to address. Right? So, this, right now, I feel like there's so much that I want to just say it out in the open. I have so many stories to share. I have so many, I have my own narrative to establish. So I will crack a regular joke if I want to. I don't want to be forced into it. Or maybe I will not do it at the cost of my own comfort level, I feel. Boundaries. I am seeing मैं कितना मिनट डिसेबिलिटी कंटेंट कर सकती हूँ, है ना? या तो and for how long I can hold the audience's attention while I am doing jokes on disability. Once I feel that maybe I cannot, then I will try to strike up a perfect balance. Where
I think you will do it. And you are doing like for like more than 2 years in comedy, I guess, right?
Yeah, more than 2 years. Yeah.
More than 2 years, and yeah. I think itna bhi agar karna kar rahe ho aur itna bhi aap karoge, so maybe in another like tum puri ek ghante ka comedy set kar sakte ho.
My primary objective is to first have an hour of jokes on disability, and then test whether it's proper type material and if it holds the audience's attention. If not, I'll obviously have to include elements that will balance things out.
I want to see you on Amazon Prime, a 1 hour show in future.
Kya baat kar rahe ho?
Please, yaar, come on.
Netflix khol do yaar. Kya hai ye?
यार ज्यादातर मैंने अमेजोन पे देखे, बट चल कोई देर दिन
एंट्री चल ठीक है अमेजोन प्राइम पे वॉचिंग दिस यस
डियर अमेजोन प्राइम एंड नेटफ्लिक्स जो है इसको ले लो यार, एक एक सेट तो इसका बनता है यार, एक आधे घंटे के दे दो किसी और को साथ रख देना, मेरे को साथ
आधे घंटे का मटेरियल है अभी, मतलब थोड़ा काम करना है उसके ऊपर, बट है आधे घंटे का,
यू कैन डू इट, यू कैन डू इट. ओके, माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. Okay, comedy wo bhi stand up karna kitna easy aur kitna mushkil, kitna hard?
Easy to main nahi bolungi,
nahi
hai easy.
Kisi ko hasana aur samne koi hase na bahut bura lagta hai,
bahut lagta hai. And I think to be a stand up comic and to grow as a stand up comic, the first thing that you need to do is to not take yourself seriously. Because let's say you really bomb hard one night, you know, you cannot afford to not go on stage for the next one whole week, because that's a proper loss of stage time. Tumhara kuch nahi ho sakta. You need to be able to take the learnings from there and then move forward and then work on your set. Having said that, comedy is hard. Like sometimes I wonder, मतलब मैं दोस्तों को कितनी बार बोलती हूँ क्या, मतलब मैं पागल थी क्या, मैं मतलब क्यों चूज like अच्छा घर पे बैठ के कंटेंट राइटिंग कर रही थी, है ना, I didn't have to move around in rickshaws or Uber then stuff, I didn't have to fall at other public places, then why am I doing this
कोई एडवेंचर करना था basically.
I think I am the geet version ki baba ji thoda aur adventure life. Haan, I think for someone like me who wants to stick to a particular narrative, there is an additional layer where I have to also challenge people's mindsets and make them comfortable or make them comfortable enough where they own their own discomfort. With regards to being open to different narratives or jokes on disability or the subject of disability as such, right? So wo hai. It's different, I would say, because it's a visual interactive live form, right? So it's not just about what I say, it's also about how I am, how I get on stage, how I stand on stage. So to give you an example, if I take time to go on stage, like let's say the host calls on a comic, right? Let's call on Rahul. Rahul will come on stage, he'll jump on stage, na? Wo do second mein stage chal jayega. But let's call on your next act, Shweta. Shweta will take time to come on stage.
Yeah, exactly. Stage,
right? Beautiful. So, and if she takes slightly more time, that will make the audience more awkward. So now is Shweta going to do something to address the discomfort, or is the audience going to stay with that discomfort and not give Shweta a chance to prove how funny she is only because she took time to get on stage?
जीत
And one thing more, क्या state accessible होते हैं?
50% नहीं होता, to be honest. हाँ, मतलब first of all, it's the level of the stage, how big your, मतलब for you ramp, stage पे ramp होना तो मतलब छोड़ दो, मतलब नहीं मतलब ठीक है, तुम वहीं से stand up कर लो, फिर comedy कर लो. But the level, first is the level of the step, or how many steps there are to get on stage. And the second is the kya bolte hai, the material of the stage hai na, of the podium. Kai baar kya hota hai ki level sahi hota hai but wahan pe wo silk material hoga niche hai na, ya to mereko wo naam nahi pata material se, but basically a very very slippery stuff on the stage where even though I can get on it, I will not be able to stand independently.
Okay.
Or sometimes they, if it's like a proper club and all, sometimes they spray something or they spray resin to make the floor look more glossy. So stuff like that. So you have to take into account all of those things. Stages are not accessible, and that's okay. I mean, and sometimes you have to just go with that.
Go with the flow. Go with the flow. Get away na. Comedy ho jayegi.
Oh, that's my biggest nightmare. For some reason, I haven't been able to crack a joke around it.
वो अपने आप ही हो जाएगा.
I can't be like, हाँ दोस्तों मैं गिरी हुई हूँ. Because that's such a huge and lame joke. I have to come up with something better.
Oh God, चलो कोई नहीं. Okay. So my next question to you is best compliment abhi tak ka or worst comment abhi tak ka.
So we'll tackle the worst first. The worst comment is
kahan se mila tha? Kahan se mila tha? Ye bata na kahan se mila tha?
Nahi meko actually thankfully mujhe yaad nahi, but it's happened more than twice where like people have simply come to you and told you that, hey, why don't you try doing regular jokes? Matlab, that's because either the narrative or the language is too harsh, or the premise of the joke is too harsh, or either like I wasn't just being funny enough, or I just wasn't being able enough to make the joke funny enough or for the audience to laugh. So I've gotten that from friends, comics. And maybe audience members too. Why don't you add that aspect also? Why don't you add that element also? Try this. Say that.
And person like me, when you say it, you can do it. Let me see. It happens. Okay. And the best?
And the best comment. Wow. So, I recently did... recently, I mean, it's time for coffee. I had done my birthday show on Zoom, and it was a great show. It was a good show. Where and I do this concept show called With This Ability, which is an hour of comedy and conversation. 25 minutes of comedy followed by conversation to talk about stereotypes and mindsets and all of that. So one of my very close friends had gotten his other friends to watch the show. And they told, and one of them I think was going through a tough time, and she was like, "Arey, I was crying an hour back, and if you would have told me that I will be smiling at night, I wouldn't believe you. But I came for the joke, came for the show. I thoroughly enjoyed her jokes, and now I feel better and lighter." Absolutely. And I'm like, wow, okay, I never saw that happening. And I mean, I still feel like that's a fluke. ho gaya one of the times. I don't think I am there yet where I can, where I'm in a position to kind of confidently say that I can change people's minds. But I'm really happy that that happened to somebody, and I'm very grateful to them that they said it to my friend.
छेड़ देवे ननद चुटकी लेवे ससुराल गेंदा फूल सास गारी देवे देवर समझा लेवे ससुराल गेंदा फूल छोड़ा बाबुल कांग ना भावे डेरा पिया का
सास गारी देवे देवर जी समझा लेवे ससुराल गेंदा फूल
सैया है व्यापारी
What does inclusion mean to you, and how, and what can we do to make spaces more accessible to you? So I'm like, yes, this is the kind of dialogue that I want going, you know, for everyone.
Basically, मतलब एक अच्छा लगता है कि कोई आके सामने से आके ऐसे पूछे यार क्या कैसा चाहते हो कि हम इसे कैसे करें? How you want this place to be accessible? Or like अगर next time आओ तो हम तुम्हारे लिए और क्या कर सकते हैं? बहुत अच्छा लगता है कि आपसे कोई पूछ रहा है. वैसे तो अदरवाइज नॉर्मल लोग इतना नहीं करते हैं, बट स्टिल सम आर गुड. मैं ये नहीं कह रहा सारी दुनिया खराब है गाइस, दुनिया अच्छी भी है, अच्छे लोग भी हैं और नॉट सो अच्छे लोग भी हैं, बट इट्स ओके, चलता है, दुनिया है, क्या कर सकते हैं, मैनेज करना पड़ेगा. सबसे बेस्ट मंत्री श्वेता मंत्री, इनसे आप कभी भी कोई जोक सुन रहे हो तो इनके पास आ जाओ और ये आपका एक डेढ़ घंटा पास करवा देंगे. ओके, any message you want to give to your audience, like kuch aisa jo aap share karna chahe ya kuch aapke paas jo aap khud batana chahte hain ya kuch kuch bhi, anything you want to, like what
is anything please come for more shows whenever that's possible in the post pandemic era. Come for more shows, support comedy. As a comedian, I would say, be open to more stories and more perspectives. You know, observational humor by a male comic is great, but that's not the only narrative that needs to exist. You know, we need to hold space for other people to share their stories and to voice their opinions as well. So, if there's someone like me who's doing jokes on disability, or if there's someone who's talking about being queer or who's talking about depression, you know, please be open to that. Give, sun lo ek bar, hai na? It won't be as bad as you think.
Exactly.
So yes, let's just create a space for everyone to have an equal voice. Number one. Number two, as a disability inclusion enabler, you know, I would just like to say ki, I just want to be in a world where inclusion is not a second thought. Like every company right now, you know, they have their like, oh my god, diversity and inclusion wing, and we do this for women and this for people with disabilities and queer people and like, why should this have to be an afterthought? And why does someone like me have to earn money by telling someone like you that this is the right way to treat a certain section of people? Like, I mean, to be very honest, I'm actually earning money to that, right? By telling able-bodied people how to be inclusive towards people with disabilities. So just want to live in a world where inclusion isn't an afterthought, where everyone's normal is a normal, you know, where there is no one single normal, there is not one norm that everybody has to adhere to, right? Sabke normal are equal and worthy of being respected, hai na? Like your normal would be a ramp, someone's normal would be a bicycle, and they're both at an equal plane, right? That and ek aur cheez bolni thi. But when I say that where inclusion is in the second thought, I also mean ki living in a world where, let's say, a boy of your age who is not disabled gets to step out of home without having to think of multiple things, right? Ki de haan chalo aaj mera man kar raha hai, main jaake cold coffee peke aaunga.
Bilkul.
Cool kids should also be able to do that without having to think ki, oh my god, main karke bahar kaise niklunga, mujhe bus transport milega ya nahi, main wahan jaunga to mujhe ramp hoga ya nahi, table milega ya nahi, ya koi mujhe haath mein koi mujhe help karega ya nahi, right?
Bilkul, so bilkul.
We should have the access to equal opportunities, be it in the personal space, social space, or the professional space.
Equality basically. हर किसी के लिए इक्वल हो, हर किसी के लिए मतलब यू नो लाइफ अगर अच्छी चले, मजेदार चले तो ज्यादा मजा आता है, और सबके लिए एक जैसी हो तो और अच्छा लगता है. ये नहीं होना चाहिए कि एक के लिए ऐसा है इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर तो दूसरे के लिए वैसा है, तो नहीं, ये नहीं, ये नहीं. एवरीथिंग शुड
और एंड व्हाई शुड समवन और अ सर्टेन सेट ऑफ पीपल डिसाइड what is normal and what is not normal? Like, what is this level of entitlement, first of all? Ki tum decide karte ho ki iska normal worthy hai, iska normal worthy nahi hai na, iska normal worthy hai to hum isko equal opportunity denge, iski life easy banegi, lekin na ye nahi, I don't want this person to kind of be a part of the mage. That's okay, I will look after or I will cater to the needs of this person later.
Bilkul.
Right? And it shouldn't depend on one's physical appearance or other accommodation needs.
Okay, good. So like Shweta, आपने सारे मेरे questions के answer बहुत अच्छे से दिए. मेरे जो सारे questions.
मुझे 1 crore rupees मिलेंगे.
पक्का, मैं आपको एक amount लिख के दे दूँगा, ऐसी आप वो copy paste करके अपने पास रख लेना. वो आपको मिल गए हैं. आपके अकाउंट में भी नहीं आएंगे, आपके सिस्टम में सेव रहेंगे, आपके मोबाइल पे और आपके सिस्टम में सेव रहेंगे, आप कभी उनका यूज कर सकते हैं. So guys, ये थी मेरे साथ श्वेता मंत्री. आई होप आपको हमारा पसंद आया होगा, जिसमें से लाइक हाफ ऑफ द टाइम हमने बहुत गप्पे मारी हैं, एंड बहुत अच्छी यू नो श्वेता ने बहुत अच्छी बातें कही हैं हमारे साथ, एंड कुछ बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट्स उन्होंने रखे हैं, एंड शी इज क्राइंग एंड शी इज अबाउट टू क्राई, रोने लग जाएंगी जैसे अनदर ऑस्कर स्पीच उनकी शायद रेडी हो रही होगी. तो आई होप नेक्स्ट वीक और मजा आएगा, और हम इंटरेस्टिंग पर्सनालिटी से हम बातें करेंगे. तो
Thank you so much for having me.
So thank you, Shweta. Thank you so much.
So guys, ये था का हमारा टॉक लिया एपिसोड. कैसा लगा आपको? प्लीज मुझे बताइएगा. मेरे को आप डीएम कर सकते हैं इंस्टाग्राम पे द बॉय ऑन बैट पपी. एंड अगर आप पॉडकास्ट सुनते हैं तो यही सेम एपिसोड आपको मेरे पॉडकास्ट यानी माई टॉपिक लिस्ट पे भी मिल जाएगा. तो गाइस थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग मी एंड या सी यू नेक्स्ट वीक सेम टाइम सेम